All right, the lights here. This card is designed to hold two lights. All right, it's a little bit narrow. One of the lights kind of sits on its edge just a little bit. However, what you want to do is you want to make sure that you have. There's three arrows here. The lower arrow here is pointing to a Velcro strap. So I get them at Home Depot. They're 1 inch wide. They're terrific. You can cut them to length, and then you can actually wrap them around, make sure your cords are in good shape. The other two spots are pointing to the fact that you need to tie your cords so that they don't come undone during the cure. Okay, that's just a reminder. And continuing on, this is how you're going to put the lights, the actual lamps, on the cart itself. The first thing you got to do is you got to put the sliders on the L bracket. I get this L bracket from Home Depot. You want to buy the one with all the holes in it, so that those holes can then be used to affix the lights themselves. That's the next slide, by the way, the how we're going to do that. But make sure you get at least two sliders. Sometimes you can use three, but the more sliders you use, the more friction you're going to have. It's going to slow down your movement of the light. It's going to make it a little bit harder. It's actually easier just with two sliders, and you'll see in the video here moving forward. So I just wanted to show you these how we're doing it real quick. I know it's not scientific. There's a lot of messy stuff in the background, but I really wanted to show you this before we started in on the videos. Yeah, and as discussed here, we got the way these lamps are actually affixed onto the L bracket at Home Depot. You just use the same screws that you use for the lights, the lamps themselves, for the handles. Just take the screws out of the handles. Those handles are threaded underneath, so you don't even need the nuts underneath. Actually, the metal's threaded, so just screw use the same nut, use the same spacer, and screw right into the L bracket and right through the handle assembly, and you'll be able to put, you know, multiple lights on the same L bracket. It sometimes can be a little bit weird because the L brackets, the way the spacing is on the holes isn't perfect, but you should be able to kind of like rig it so that it's right. You can go either way, by the way. You can put you go on either side of the L bracket, so whichever one works the best, you should use. You could always turn them around as well. But what you want to do is, you can see right in the center, right between the right two circles with the arrow, it's pointing towards the slider. But right next to the slider, there's a Velcro strap. I strapped that light cord super tight around the L bracket so that it stays low. You want it to stay low so that when you actually start to use it, if there's any things in the way, that the cord isn't sticking out, like any overhang lights or anything like that, you're going to end up either, you know, swing damaging whatever. And this is the final slide on this thing. And the reason why I'm showing you this is because you can see how those sliders are positioned. One is well behind the lights, and one is right around the middle of the lights. What this allows you to do, depending on the length of your island or the width of your island, allows you to get a little bit more length out of your boom. The boom's only 84 inches long, and if you need a longer boom, you can use one of these L brackets with a couple of these sliders. You don't need to buy another boom. You can just use L brackets with these sliders, and you can see that this thing is about 6 inches longer. It'll go out about 6 inches longer than the actual boom itself, so that light can go out over the bar, over the countertop, and then you can have control by sliding it back and forth using those two lights. So you don't necessarily ever need to buy another boom or a boom arm. You just use the same boom arm, and you can get a 48-inch L bracket or even a longer one, and you can kind of like mess with that a little bit. It really depends on how long your cord is on your light. I really want a light cord. I want to kind of standardize these light cords at about 15 feet so that we can get at least 10 feet out over the boom, and then have the thing go up and over so that you have enough room. We all have enough room to move when it comes to these things. Having a larger light would always be key, but this is going to be a way to use two lights on a very large island. And in a second, you'll see that, you know, the 65 square foot island, and curing it for, you know, 30 something minutes isn't necessarily, if you could cut that time in half, that's very beneficial to you. But it's actually, for me, I've been noticing that the cure itself is much harder and more consistent, with a lot fewer movement, a lot less movement, and it looks a lot better once the cure is done. It's a lot easier to sand. So that's kind of how we do it, how we put the lamps on the curing cart. And the next thing you're going to see is going to be how I use the curing cart with those two lamps. And this is the way the lights hang on the curing cart. As you can see, I have a very tightly wound Velcro strap that's holding the L bracket to these two cords. These two cords are now going to be easy for me to pull back and forth using this L bracket. Don't worry if your lights are slightly askew. It doesn't matter. You're going to get a wonderful cure, a really nice tight cure. And it doesn't matter if the lights having a little bit of dispersion, it's okay. You know, they don't have to be perfectly aligned. You know, sometimes that might not be good because you're going to kind of burn the UV into the material in the same spot. Whereas it's kind of like askew, you're kind of getting a diffused cure. So that's kind of how I see it anyways. Now, this is just best practice from the curing cart. Some people do it differently. This is the way I do it, and I think it's the way it's been the most success. Sorry. Warm up your lights, your lamps off-site. Make it at least 10 feet away so that you're not going to end up, you know, affecting the wet Antietch or anything that's on the surface. Allow your lamps to warm up 2-3 minutes more. You know, get them as bright as possible. Once you swing over, go quickly with your pin. You're going to pin 24 inches high. With the cart at the highest possible setting, you're going to pin at the highest possible setting. Then you're going to go down about halfway. You're going to do that, they say about 5% of the cure, and I think that's probably about right. So what you just saw me do is at 24. Right now I'm lowering it to 12, and I'm going to roll over it the countertop for another minute or two as fast as I can. And then I'm going to just bathing the Antietch in UV light. As you can see, the countertops on the surrounding area have already been completed, so I don't have to worry too much about that. We did that at an earlier date. This island wasn't ready on the previous project. Now, as you can see right now, the way I'm walking with the curing light, I have my hand on the bar. That's the easiest way to do it. Just have your hand on the bar, pushing it back and forth. There's a handle on the curing cart, but that's just really to move it back, moving it towards the van and stuff. This bar is really the best handle to use when moving the thing back and forth. Okay, so you're going to see me move this thing, and then I'm going to lower it. And when I lower it, I'm going to be lowering this thing, and actually I'm lowering it right now. You're going to see, like, I actually can't find the level. I can't find the place where I need to lower it to. It seems a little low. It's a little bit... The curing cart actually comes with a stopper. You can put the stopper right on that rail. You can experiment with it prior to curing it, so you don't have to worry about any of the any issues when it comes to trying to find the right depth. That's super important. You should also know the length of this bar. You can see that the lamp isn't quite reaching the outside edge, and you're going to see me. I'm going to do one or two passes here, and you're going to see me move to the other side because you can see I'm kind of strained right now. I'm not on the right side of the curing cart using the right handle. Now I'm going to extend out the arm, and I'm going to move myself to the right side of the curing cart, and then I'll be golden, and we'll just be rolling from then on out. Actually, I didn't move myself yet, but you'll see it happening shortly. And I'm just going to speed this thing up so that we can get through it. But I just wanted you guys to get the idea of how you can quickly and easily cure a huge island in half the time and have a really nice cure without having any issues and any texture or you know, any like major texture. Nothing that needed to be sanded out or filled. I think there might have been a couple little holes in this island, maybe like a half a dozen that we had to fill, and that's pretty much it. So enjoy the rest of the video, and if there's anything any questions that you have, please let me know.